This morning the plan is to go out to Namatjira, drive out towards Ormiston Gorge and check out along the road, see what's out there. Certainly worked out where the, well, so far where the photographic spots are, because they just widened the road that little bit so you could stop there and take the photos. Doesn't always happen. I asked some friends if there was anywhere out along the road here that you could sort of camp. No, not really, they said. Well, I've seen two so far, and I'm only about 20k, not even 20k out of town yet. Just thinking there are actually farms or stations all the way along the bottom of these hills, and the school bus does a run out here. I wonder if these kids realise how lucky they are to be able to travel through this sort of country every day of the week. But then again, I suppose you get to a point where maybe you get a little blasé about some of these things. Back to the main road. Namatjira Drive. Stopping point coming up shortly. Oh, look at that there on the right. 24-hour overnight camping allowed. So there is plenty of camping opportunities here. Side of a hill. Look at that. And that country through there is Aboriginal country. Just here in parks and garden stuff. Yeah, so I can think of worse places to stop than here. But yeah, there was a bit of a breeze out there this morning. Just a touch of breeze. Just talking to a couple of guys from New South Wales. We're on the way to Kings Canyon. Where are you from, New South Wales? Don't want to go back. Oh dear. Ellery Creek, a big hole. Okay. Right. it's got the phone hotspot on it as well. Little high grade lookout. And 24-hour camping is allowed. Oh. Thinking you wouldn't want to have vertigo and drive too close to the right hand edge of the road because it's just a drop straight down. One can't help but notice that all of these lookouts, and we assume that the guy is a white guy, I've got a white guy names, Neil Hargrave, lookout. I doubt that he's a black fella, but he could be, who knows. That's a pretty handsome looking set of mountains directly in front of us there. Okay, so the ochre pits turn off. Ochre occurs in a range of earthy colours, ranging from white, yellow, orange, red and browns. It's an important part of Aboriginal culture, and it's used in everyday life. It's the raw material for paintings and ceremonial body decoration. Weapons were painted with ochre to increase the success of hunting and to protect the wooden weapons from termites. Red ochre was mixed into an ointment to relieve decongestion, white ochre used as a magical charm. Well, that was the ochre pits, and it's good to see that they're putting some pathways down some of these places so that people who do have some impairment can actually get to see them, go and have a look. Judging by the wheel marks beside the car road there, I'm not the only one who's fascinated by these hills. Okay, Ormiston Gorge. The kiosk is open. A few people camping here. Getting a bit warm, isn't it? 30?
Yeah.
I just did 30 metres, that killed me. That guy reckons he's just hiked 30 kilometres. Whoa. Tell you what, it's quite warm out there now. But the air, when it's moving, is okay. But the sun, yeah, it's got bite. Well and truly. I only walked down as far as the pool. I didn't go down below to see what was... how the pool sort of integrated with the rest of the gorge, but certainly just the drive end. That's the magnificence of the place as you go in there. Well worth it. Coming up to the main road again. Well, it just keeps on coming. Generator going there. Or a pump or something. Glen Helen Gorge, 300 metres. I see, so it's Glen Helen Gorge that we were looking at. Hotel and camping guests report the coach parking to the right. There is Glen Helen Gorge, I see. Okay. So the Mount Sonda lookout. Thank you. turn up to Red Bank Gorge. This is Red Bank Gorge. Uh-oh. Area is up the top. This is driving into the day use area. From here, I guess you go hiking. Red Bank Gorge, 1.2 kilometres, 30 minutes one way. Wow. There's still a couple of things I'd like to have a look at, but it's now 20 past two. Yeah, I think we're going to call it a day and start heading back into Alice Springs. Thank you. you're going back along the same road you've been on up is that you get to see everything that was only in the rear vision mirror when you're going the other way. Seven times chalet bush camping. We actually didn't go into that. Simpson Gap is to the left. This is rather awesome. Because of a number of factors, including the distances to be covered and the time factor, the heat of the day, hiking distances, a lack of fitness and a dodgy back, I decided that I'd only do the short walks as it was. I pushed it, fit it all in, and still didn't see everything I wanted to. If you enjoyed this video, there's over 200 more just like it on this channel. Subscribe and hit the notification bell, and we'll let you know when our next video is available. Thanks for watching.